What's up everyone, it's Kalen Moss, aka the Minute Admin here, and in this video, I'll show you how to pass the Salesforce Admin certification in the easiest way possible. So, this video is highly requested from a lot of viewers on this channel, and basically what I'm gonna show you how to do is show up to the Salesforce Admin exam with a completely different mindset than you're probably used to. So let's just go ahead and get started here. So I'm gonna just talk about really quickly the Salesforce Admin Certification Exam Guide. So I went to trailhead.salesforce.com and I'm going to go to the exam outline for the Salesforce Certified Administrator Certification. And the exam outline for the Salesforce Certified Admin Cert has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 sections total on the exam outline. So all of these sections equal up to 100% of the certification, pretty much 100% of what the certification is going to cover here. So if we look at something like configuration and setup, that's going to be 20% of the exam. The second part's going to be Object Manager and Lightning App Builder, 20% of the exam. Notice under each section, we have different bullet points here. So under config and setup, we have 2, 4, 6 different bullet points right here. And then we have 3 bullet points under Object Manager and Lightning App Builder. So what I did was I took every exam section on the Salesforce Admin Cert and I broke it down into the bullet points, which Salesforce already did for you. But what I did was took it a step further so I can break down these bullet points into easy to understand terms. So whenever you're studying for this certification, it's as easy as possible. So just remember, if you don't have any context behind what I'm doing in this video, the other video which explains my whole process in depth is going to be linked to this video right here. So you can find that in the description below, or you can find it as a card that's going to be popping up somewhere in the top right portion of the screen right now. So if you don't understand the full concept behind this, then just go ahead and check out that last video that shows you the mind frame and the way that I broke this exam section down. And let's go to the actual breakdown of this in the Lucid chart that I created for you. So the Lucid chart that I created for you is going to be based off of a real world Salesforce scenario here. So I just made up this scenario, which is Elon Musk wants to sell more Tesla Model S's in the month of July. This is the same scenario as I had in my previous video, the one that's linked in the description below. And basically Elon Musk wants to sell more Tesla Model S's in the month of July or August or whenever you're watching this video, or just think about it and whenever Elon wants to sell more Model S's. So he wants to sell more Model S's in the month of July. How's Elon gonna sell more Model S's, Tesla Model S's in the month of July? He's gonna run a July marketing campaign to sell 100,000 Model S cars. The end goal for Elon is to automate the sales and service processes for Tesla sales reps and customer service team. So how did I get to that level right there? How did I find out that that was gonna be the end goal? Well, I broke the exam guide up into 7 different sections. Remember, the exam guide from a little bit earlier is broken down into how many sections? It's 2, 4, 6, 7 different sections on the Salesforce Admin exam guide. So the first section that makes the most sense is to set up Sales Cloud for Tesla. And as we can see here, that's configuration and setup, which is 20% of the test. And then we see the second set, or the second step in the exam guide, is to set up objects, fields, page layouts, and record types for Tesla. So the second section is going to be Object Manager and Lightning App Builder. So if we go back to this exam outline, these are the first 2 sections right here. So the first 2 sections you really need to set up, if you're going to be working for Tesla, the first thing that you would ever think of doing would be configuration and setup here. And then once you configure Sales Cloud and you set it up, the second thing you'll be doing is you'll be setting up objects in pretty much standard and custom objects. So that's why that's the second step for this project if we're doing a real world project, or I would say a real world implementation of Sales Cloud into Tesla. The third step is going to be importing clean Tesla data, and setting up Tesla's reports and dashboards. Now, in the third step, that's going to pretty much be correlated to data and analytics management, which is going to be right here, 14% of the exam. So as you can see from the exam outline, that's not necessarily how it's set up, because we have 1, 2, 3 different sections right here, right before we even get to data and analytics management. But that's not the most logical step. So if I was to be implementing Sales Cloud for Tesla, the first thing I would do is configuration and setup, Object Manager and Lightning App Builder. And then the third thing I would do is import my clean data once I have all my standard and custom objects set up. So that's why this is the third section right here. So you're not going to be really doing productivity and collaboration until you start importing your data and things like that. It's just the most logical thing that I came up with. So this is the third step. Fourth step is setting up the sales process for Tesla sales agents, sales and marketing applications. Fifth step, set up case management so Tesla can help customers. 11% of the test, service and support applications. Automate data and processes, which is your workflow and process automation section. And then figure out how to make Tesla sales reps more productive and collaborative. So now that you've got the whole Sales Cloud org set up, you want to now start talking about productivity and collaboration, which is 7% of the exam right here. So this is actually going to be the last thing that you need to be focused on if you're doing a real world implementation for Tesla. Remember, if this doesn't really make sense, go back to that video in the description below or in that card that's in the top right portion of the screen, and you can go back and reference what's really going on here. But hopefully you understand that if you're implementing Sales Cloud for a company like Tesla, you need to follow a structure. You need to follow some sort of framework. And that framework is, the first one is configuring and setting up, Object Manager and Lightning App Builder, data analytics and management. Basically everything that you would really do in a real world project implementation for a company. So that's what this lucid chart does. Now, as you can see underneath each section that I just showed you, we have questions. Now, why did I turn these bullets underneath each section into questions? Now, that's going to be covered in depth in the previous video, the one in the description below. But basically, you want to think about, if you're working at Tesla, you're going to be asking questions when you're implementing Salesforce for a company like Tesla. So if you're doing configuration and setup, 20% of the test, what's the first question you're going to ask? Now, think about it. If the only questions you had to ask were the questions that related to the bullet points right here, what would you ask? This is how I broke everything down into layman's terms. So every bullet right here is actually a question on the lucid chart that I created for you. So the first question you would ask is, how do we set up company settings in Sales Cloud for Tesla? Which relates to like fiscal year, business hours, currency management, default settings. That's all going to be this first bullet point right here. How do we set that stuff up, like fiscal year? So, right? So we have the first question. Second question is, what are the sharing settings for Tesla? Like, what are the public groups we need to create? The org-wide defaults we need to set up? The roles, subordinates, hierarchy, reports, and dashboard folders? That's going to be this section right here, or this bullet point right here. And then the third question, all the way down to the sixth question, is going to be related to a bullet that is on this under this section right here. Now, if we go to the next section, which is Object Manager and Lightning App Builder, 20% of the test. Remember, all the questions that we're asking are as if we were doing a real world implementation. So we're asking Tesla, or we're asking Elon Musk, hey, what's the right data model for standard and custom objects? Like, we're going to create these standard object, or we're going to create these custom objects. We've got these standard objects. How do we need to link all of these together with master detail relationships, lookup relationships, junction relationships, and record types? So hopefully you're starting to see that all I've done here for each question is pretty much just taken the bullets, these difficult to read bullets that are pretty technical for people to try to figure out, and I've just turned them into real world layman's terms questions, just easy to understand questions that make it relatable as if you were actually doing this implementation for a company like Tesla. So hopefully you can see that when you start asking yourself questions to actually implement something for a real company, then you start to see what you actually need to know to pass the test. So once you start to understand, hey, I need to know all about master detail relationship, lookups, junction objects, or junction relationships, record types, you start to see, okay, what is a record type? Okay, how do I set up a record type? What's a lookup relationship? How do I actually understand what that actually means? So hopefully you start to see the wheels start spinning, and whenever you start asking yourself these questions, then the answers become very apparent, and your studying for the Salesforce Admin certification becomes so much easier. So I'm not going to go through the whole entire exam outline right here, but just know that for each section on the test, we have all of the bullet points covered here in question format so that you can easily understand what Salesforce wants you to know in order to be ready for the Salesforce Admin certification. Now, one thing I did for you to upgrade your experience here was I actually created a downloadable PDF of this exact exam outline right here and broke it down for you so you can study it, and hopefully it helps you to understand what you need to know for the test, and that way you can pretty much come into the Salesforce Admin certification ready to rock and roll once you understand exactly what each question is trying to get you to understand. So that's all I've got for you for this video. Once again, watch the video prior to this one, the one that is before this one, the one that is linked in the description below, and it's also in the card up in the top right portion of this video. You can click on that, find that, watch both of those videos, watch this one, watch that previous one, keep on watching them to understand the process to actually pass any Salesforce certification. Like I said, this is a highly requested video, and this is for all of the people who asked for this video. Hopefully you enjoy it, and hopefully you also download that PDF and get some value out of that PDF so you can study for the exam, pass the Salesforce Admin exam, and get yourself a Salesforce job. So thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, hit that thumbs up button and make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any future Minute Admin videos. Thanks.